Hi, I'm Rowan from Vantage Admissions, and in this video, we're going to go through everything you need to know if you're planning to take the ESAT for the 2026 admission cycle. The ESAT is an undergraduate admissions test taken by students in year 13 in support of their UCAS applications. It's required by some courses in physics, engineering, chemical engineering, natural sciences, and veterinary medicine. The exam was introduced for the first time in 2024, although in many ways it's the natural continuation of the NSAA and the ENGA, two older exams which ran between 2016 and 2023. The ESAT is administered by UAT UK, University Admissions Tests UK, alongside Pearson VUE. It's a computer-based exam for which you register online and sit the exam at a Pearson VUE test centre. It's computer-based. You use a computer interface to input your answers to the multiple choice problems, although you will also have an erasable notebook for writing written workings. There is a fee associated with registering, although in many cases students may be eligible for bursaries. Although the ESAT was originally only required for students applying to study at Cambridge or Imperial, for the first time for 2026 entry, University College London are adding an ESAT requirement for those students applying to study electrical and electronic engineering. For Cambridge, ESAT plays the role previously occupied by the NSAA and the ENGA. It's mandatory for those students applying to study natural sciences, engineering, chemical engineering, and veterinary medicine. And the ESAT score is used in combination with predicted grades to shortlist candidates for interview. Imperial requires the ESAT of those students applying to study physics, as well as all engineering disciplines. For 2026 entry, there will also be an interview for those students applying to study engineering. There are two exam sittings for the ESAT, one in October and one in January. Applicants to Cambridge are required to take the October sitting, since the interviews will take place in late November and early December. Applicants to Imperial may also prefer to take the October sitting so that they will be eligible for an earlier interview. You can only take the ESAT once per admission cycle, and for the 2025-2026 round, the dates will be the 9th or 10th of October and the 6th or 7th of January. Registration for the ESAT generally closes roughly 3 weeks before a given sitting, but check the UAT UK website linked in the description box for specifics. The format of the ESAT is roughly similar to NSAA Section 1, with five separate modules: Mathematics 1, Mathematics 2, Physics, Chemistry, and Biology. For almost all courses, applicants will sit three modules overall, and everybody sits Mathematics 1. The modules are timed separately, with 40 minutes for each module, in which you're required to attempt 27 multiple choice questions. It must be emphasised that the ESAT is a highly time-pressured exam. For Imperial, all applicants will have their module selection mandated by the course. The same is the case for Cambridge engineering applicants. Applicants to Cambridge to study natural sciences, chemical engineering, or veterinary medicine, as well as applicants to UCL to study electrical engineering, will have freedom in selecting their final two modules. For students with a choice of modules, it's worth seriously considering Mathematics 2 to minimise the overall number of subjects that you'll need to prepare for. It's worthwhile to attempt all relevant modules for 3 years of past papers, for example, using NSAA Section 1, to get an idea of which modules are likely to be the most straightforward for you. Don't necessarily assume that the subject you find easiest in school will be the subject you find easiest on the ESAT. In terms of relevant past paper series, for Maths 1, Physics, Chemistry, and Biology, the NSAA Section 1 is closest to the modern ESAT. The ENGA is also very helpful for Physics, as well as both Maths papers. Applicants who will be taking Maths 2 should also use TMUA, especially TMUA Paper 1, for further practice. We'll be releasing a more detailed video on past papers for the ESAT very shortly. Results for the ESAT are automatically sent to any course you apply for which features an ESAT requirement. Courses without an explicit ESAT requirement will not receive your score. You'll be given your score roughly 4 weeks after you sit the test, with scores scaled from 1.0 to 9.0. You receive a separate score for each module, and although different candidates may take different questions, for example on different days, the scores are statistically equated so that the scores of candidates taking the exam on different days can still be compared. Do be aware that the scaling changed substantially in 2024, so that scaled scores on, for example, the NSAA or the ENGA are not necessarily equivalent to scaled scores on the current ESAT. The new scale is such that 4.5 is a roughly typical score, and around 10% of candidates will score 7.0 or higher. Candidates aiming to take the ESAT to strengthen their applications should therefore be targeting a score of 6.0 to 7.0 as a minimum. The required knowledge for ESAT is fairly basic. The syllabus for Mathematics 1 broadly aligns with the content taught in GCSE Mathematics, and likewise for the science papers, physics, chemistry, and biology, the content is broadly at a GCSE level with some first year A-level content. Mathematics 2 does make heavier use of first year single mathematics A-level, which broadly aligns with what you'd study in the first year of Mathematics IB. It's a good idea to read through the entire published specification point by point. Different GCSE and A-level exam boards may emphasise certain topics differently, and it's very important to make sure you're familiar with specifically with what's going to be required on the ESAT. Pay particular attention to topics which you haven't studied since GCSE, since many of these topics may be in need of a refresher. Likewise, do pay attention to non-examinable A-level topics. ESAT questions are designed with very particular methods in mind and may be constructed such that good things will happen if you apply a certain method. If you go off the beaten track and use approaches which are outside the intended specification, it's more likely that you might run into trouble. It should also be emphasised that although the specification for the ESAT is very basic, there is a large body of commonly recurring tricks and techniques which are not published on the specification, but which you will encounter again and again on the relevant past paper series. Do remember to subscribe for more videos on the ESAT, including more details on required ESAT knowledge, recommended past papers, and preparation advice. There will also be lots of videos on broader aspects of the application process, as well as some exciting maths and physics content.